14-1 in real price. And bang on the ninth and playing at second base is Ron Dunn. It's Madera, Zoo, Wood, Esquivez, Renteria, Garibay, Williams, Price, and Dunn. So those are the schedule. Here's defensive alignment for Chabot Gladiators. Playing in left field, Drew Benetti. Owens in center field, Fieldfoot at right field, Costello at third base, Walsh at shortstop, Berman will play at second base, Feeney is playing at first, and then behind the plate doing the catching is Forsythe's on the mound, and then for Chabot is Marquez. Pitch a swing and a miss. And it's now 0-2. The first pitch was at 2:28 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. The game time temperature, 71 degrees. No balls and two strikes. The count was just underway here. Here comes the pitch. And strike three called as Madura is out of there on strikes. One man gone. First strikeout for
number 8, Mark Zoo.
So on the mound this afternoon for his number 35, that pitch is outside for a ball 1-0. The starter for today is the X-Man Javier Masquez, a 6-foot freshman from San Leandro, California, not far from there. The next pitch, Mark Zoo swings and that one goes foul. It is strike one for Zoo. Evens the count at 1-1. It's the set here because the pitch and Zoo swings and that one goes foul. Now it's a 1-2 count. 1-2 to count. Chabot coming off a hot roll coming in there, 20-8 overall. The next pitch is Zoo hits a ground ball to the third baseman Costello. He throws over to the first baseman Feeney, and Zoo is gone. Two men gone. 4-3. Your put out.
Number 44, Jackson Wood.
I bring up Jackson Wood to the plate. Jackson Wood. Breaking out of his slump, got the hit. For the Rams hitters, they're 3-4-5 hitters. The highlight lineup is 1-38 in their last 39 plate appearances. Pitch is high out there for a ball, 1-0. Jackson Wood is from San Mateo with the Hillsdale High School. Not just across the bridge, San Mateo Bridge from here. Here is the pitch. That pitch is missing outside the plate for a ball. It evens now the count at 1-1. Or a 2-0, I should say, correction. It's the sign. Here's the pitch. In there for a strike. It's even now. It's 2-1.
Good.
That's 2-1 count. Give me all the stats and stories throughout this game. And the next pitch is in there for a strike. And it's now 2-2.
Good.
Even count, 2-2 with 2 outs. That's getting underway here. Here's the pitch. And that's just missing. Now the count is now 3-2. Here comes the pitch. And that is a ball 4.
Wood.
So Wood will reach on base with a 2-out walk.
Now batting Number 22, Miguel Esquivez.
Go, Miguel. Miguel Esquivez to the plate. With two outs. Esquivez at the plate. Here comes the pitch. And that pitch is in there for a call, strike one, and it's now 0-1. Gets the set. And throw back over there as Marquez throws it right back over to Feeney, the first baseman. Have a no ball, one strike count. Here's the pitch. That's way high as for the catcher coming out of the squat to get to retrieve that ball. It's Foresight. Hits the set. Here comes the pitch. As Esquivez swings and that one goes foul. It's now one ball, two strikes a count. Nice, beautiful day here in the East Bay. One ball and two strikes a count. Here comes the pitch. As Esquivez hits one into right field for a base hit.
Now batting number 25.
So now Wood will advance to second. So now the Rams 3-4-5 hitters are now just only just 2-for-39 in their last 41 plate appearances. Jordan Renteria is at the plate now for San Francisco to pitch as he hits a ground ball as a chopper. Could be a tough play for Feeney. He will throw over to the X-Man Marquez and the retired Renteria. So that's a 3-1 putout. That's it. So, that's no runs on one hit. Rams lead the pair as the Rams 3-4-5 hitters are now, they're now just two for 40 in their last 42 plate appearances between that the Harlem lineup. So it's no score. The Rams nothing, and the Gladiators of Chabot College are coming up. Comes in beginning with the on a roll. They come in with a 20-8 record, 20-9 overall, and they got 9 wins. They're 7-2 in conference play. We'll give you the lineups in just a moment. Here's the first pitch to the leadoff man. It is leading off will be Colin Fukuki from Honolulu, Hawaii. He'll bat first. then bags second as Montoya kicks and throws as a liner off the through under the head of Montoya in the center field for a base hit. And boy,
batting for the Gladiators.
Montoya had to die for that ball. Had to hit down low because it's going directly to his head. Bukowski will reach out with a single. So then now, Bang set, it will be Emmett Feeney. Feeney will bat second. Then Bang third, the shortstop will be Nicholas Walsh. Nick Walsh throws a second, and it's not in time as Esquivez could not get the throw in time. And just like that, the Highlanders have a runners on base, a stolen base. So it's Nick Walsh will play at second. Then playing at first base is Daniel Brenneman. That would be playing at first base. It will be Emmett Feeney at first base. Then Bang third will be Walsh. Bang fourth will be Brenneman. Then Bang fifth, the designated hitter will be the DH for the Highlanders will be Noah Morton. And then batting sixth will be the TJ Costello will play on the hot corner at third. Batting seventh will be Liam Forsythe. As that's a swing and a miss by Feeney. Now it's a 2-1 count. And then batting eighth is Gabe DiBenedetto. He will play in left field, and the batting ninth will be, and he swings and that one goes foul. Jalen Owens will play in center field and he will bat ninth. Defensive alignment for San Francisco as we'll give you the defensive alignment in just a bit. We have a 2-ball-1-strike count. Two balls and one strike to count. Here's the pitch. Oh, just missing a breaking ball and just missing. 3-1. So playing in left field is Williams in left field. 3-1, pop up. Foul territory, and it will run out of real estate as the count's full. Williams in left field. Maduro will play in center. We'll play in center field. And playing in right field will be Williams. Here comes the pitch, and it's ball four. Williams in right field again. Williams are playing, Price will be in right field. Price will be in right field, and then the shortstop will be Zhu. Here's the pitch outside for a ball. Then playing at second base will be Dutt. Dutt at second. Garibay at third. That's a high fly ball into deep right center field. Coming up in there with a catch is the right fielder Price. Coming up the score standing up So that is an RBI, and that was Walsh. Give him
to Daniel.
He will stay at first base on that walk. It's a the right fielder coming up there with the catch. It is an RBI, and the Gladiators take a 1-0 lead as Fukuoki scores from that from third. That pitch is a ball. Now it's 2-0. Two balls and one strike to count. Beautiful, picturesque shot here. And it's a high fly pop up. And Costello pops it up. It's the second baseman coming over there. Camping under there is Ron Dutt with the catch.
For the Gladiators, 34, Noah Morton.
Noah Morton will come up now for with two men gone. Two men gone, Noah Dutt. And going back over to second base is Feeney. And advancing to second, by the way, on. Or is he at second base, as I say? Here's the pitch. And a line shot foul down the right field line goes out of play. Goes nearby the Rams bullpen. Count will be 0-1. So it's an 0-1 count. No balls and one strike to count. Here's the pitch. Breaking ball just missing. It's now 2-1. We'll give you all the stats and stories of this game and more throughout this contest. Underway here, you guys watch us on StreamLiveHD.com/CityCollegeBaseball. 1-1. As Montoya giving them that breaking pitch as Morton fouls that one down. Strike two. One, two, coming. Here's the pitch. And Morton stays alive, and he battling, fouling that one back. So it's still one ball, two strikes here. One ball, two strikes to count. It's the stretch. Here comes the pitch. That pitch is high and now evens the count now at 2-2. On deck for waiting on the on deck stirrup goes TJ Costello. It's the set. 2-2 pitch coming. And now it's outside. Now count is full. See if Feeney will be running on 3-2. He got a pretty good lead. Three balls, two strikes with two outs. 1-0. Gladiators leading San Francisco. Here comes the pitch. and the 3-2 pitch, and just that's a hit by pitch, or it wouldn't have mattered, because even if he would have hit him.
Batting to the
plate,
number
27,
TJ.
That's a big problem for the Rams pitchers. You're ahead of the one ball, two strike, 2-2, 1-2, 2-2. And you go up to 3-2 and just have not been able to. And you have to challenge the hitters at the 3-2. Try to challenge them, make them earn their at bats. Here's the pitch to Costello. That pitch is a called strike, 0-1. Got to have control of your pitch. You got to, you know, you got to have control of that. You have to, you know, try to attack. You got to be aggressive when you're ahead of the count. See what we're going to do. Here comes the 0-1 pitch. That's in there for a strike. It's now 0-2.
Come on, 2-7. It only takes one. Here we go. 2-7, come on.
We have no balls and two strikes to count. Two outs. It's the set. The pitch. Strike three, called as Costello is going on strikes. Strikeout number one for Max Montoya. That's a strikeout for Jordan Montoya. Jordan Mad Max Montoya. So that's it for Chabot. They get one run on one hit. And they leave, they end up leaving a pair on base. So after a full complete inning, it's Chabot Gladiators 1 and San Francisco Rams. Nothing.
Number 14, Angel Garibay.
So Angel Garibay will be scheduled for San Francisco. As the X-Man Marquez goes back out there for a second inning look. The softball lefty throws, and it's a pitch in there for a called strike, 1-0-1.
Go, Angel!
It's a set. And the pitch is missing for a ball. Evens the count at 1-1. Evens the count at 1-1. Hits the set. Here comes the pitch. That's low in there for a ball. Now it's now 2-1. Here comes the pitch. And did it hit him? No, it did not. So now it's going to be 3-1. So now it's a 3-ball, 1-strike count. Here comes the pitch. Way outside, it's 4. So it's 4.
Now batting number 6, Donovan Williams.
So leading off with a walk would be Garibay. Donovan Williams will come to the plate for San Francisco. And here comes a pitch, and Williams trying to lay a bunt. Throw back to first, and they got him! Great play by the catcher, Forsythe, as they were able to pick off Garaby. Garaby is gone. Oh. As argument proceeding by yep, so Garaby is picked off, got caught in grandma's cookie jar. So that would be a 3-1 pull, or it would be a kind of a 2-3 caught stealing. Garaby is out of there, one man gone. That pitch is in there for a strike, and it's now 0-2. No balls and two strikes to count. Well, give me what's going on around the CCCAA Community College Baseball scoreboard and what's all the action going on this afternoon. Plus, we'll give you all the action, what's going on in college baseball scoreboard as well, and Major League Baseball. 1-2 to count. Here's the pitch. That's upstairs high for a ball. Now it is 2-2. Two balls and two strikes to count. Here comes the pitch. And it's now a full count, 3-2. For Donovan Williams. Price is the on-deck hitter for the Rams. Here's the pitch. Williams chops one to the shortstop, Walsh. Walsh throws and scoops up the ice cream by Feeney. Two men gone. 6-3 put out. Great play by the shortstop, Walsh, and then rifles over to Feeney, the first baseman, and he scooped that baseball up like scooping up some ice cream. Two men gone. And the pitch is in there for a called strike one. That now is Emile Price coming to the plate for San Francisco. A 6'1" sophomore from Oakland Tech High School over there in Oakland, not about 15, 20 minutes from here. Here's the pitch. That's low and down, and scoops by away the catcher, Forsythe. Oakland Tech High School is over there in Oakland, as not far from the MacArthur BART station. As you're heading towards North Oakland, as you commute on BART, either you're going to be either taking the Richmond train, either heading towards Berkeley, or as Price, it's a ground ball. That's a fair ball, and they got him! A great play by the Gladiators third baseman, TJ Costello, coming up with the web jam and rifling from third to the first baseman, Feeney, and the inning is over. No runs, no hits, nobody left for San Francisco. And after an inning and a half, it is the Rams trailing the Gladiators.
6.
To the top of the, or the bottom of the second inning. So we now go to the, and it whips a try to deep left field, and that goes foul. The catcher Forsythe for Liam Forsythe, the catcher who did the caught stealing on Williams back in the previous frame. And here comes the pitch. That's way outside for a ball. It's now 1-1. Here comes the 1-1 pitch as Forsythe swings and misses, and it's now 1-2. Here comes the 1-2 pitch on the way, and Forsythe's able to hold off on that. Now it's an even count at 2-2. The 2-ball, 2-strike to count. Here comes the pitch. And that is, no, just missing. Just missing. It looked like, it was like a 3-second delay, and they did not, and Montoya did not get the call. Just missing. Full count, 3-2. Look upstairs, it looked like it was a bang, bang strike they called, but it's not. Montoya rocks in the set. Here comes the pitch. And it's a high fly ball to center field. Back goes Medina at the wall. And that ball is gone. Touch them all. That is a home run. A solo shot by Liam Forsythe. As the Gladiators now extend their lead to 2-0. And boy, that was a kind of a bad, a good break, a big break for the Gladiators, as Montoya did not get that third strike, and then a bad break for the Rams. They didn't get that strike three that should have put away Forsythe, and Forsythe took full advantage of it, and he launched one to deep left center field, and as the Gladiators now extend their lead to 2-0. That's an RBI, but that was a bad break for the Rams and for Montoya. Here's the pitch. And boy, it just shows you where they are now coming into this game. They've lost 6 in a row, 9 of their last 11 games. A 1-2. That's a high fly pop-up in the foul territory. Garibay giving it a looks at it and goes out of play. Looking at the stats for San Francisco, they come in right now 8-18 overall, 2-7 in conference play. They're just 2-3 at home, 3-10 away from, and they're 3-5 on a neutral site. As deep in, Denio pops it up, and that is the second baseman. Comes up with it and makes the catch. So now coming to the plate will be Jalen Owens. Jalen Owens will come to the plate. Here's the pitch, is high for a ball, 1-0. That pitch is high in it for a ball, 1 ball, no strikes. And he swings and misses, is now evens the count at 1-1. Gets the set. Here comes the pitch. Breaking ball just outside corner for a ball. Now it's 2-1. Gets the set. The pitch. Oh, out hit the inside corner, strike two. And the pitch is swung on and missed. That ball is going into the bat and to the out of play, and he's going to go for two. A two base strikeout. Oh, my. That's a very rarely. You rarely see something like that. And we're trying to get us, see what we should score that. Huh? That's going to be a wild pitch.
For the Raiders, number 9.
I mean, a wild pitch as Owen strikeout. Second strikeout, but doesn't feel like the strikeout will have an asterisk because Montoya threw a wild pitch as Owens not only he ended up getting two bases and a drive in the center field coming up and make the catch is Medina. He's going to tag and it's going to be no play. Zoom will be able to come up as Owens is going to advance to third.
Batting for the Gladiators, number 21.
And such a bad, that's another bad break. So, that's just how it is when you get a strikeout, but it does not matter because of the, you know, do a wild pitch. And not only that, Owens not only strike out, but because the ball, the way the wild pitch went, he ended up kept on going and getting two bases. Now the Gladiators now have runners at third with two outs. Now back to the top of the here's the pitch, popped up. It's the deep left center field. It is the left fielder coming in there is Williams to make the catch and the inning is over. And that's it for Chabot. They get one more run on no. They get one run. And they get one hit, and it could have been much worse. It was a home run by the catcher, Liam Forsythe, and after two full complete here on the campus of Chabot College in Hayward, it's the Gladiators leading your San Francisco Rams 2-0. Here we go. So we now go to the third inning. That pitch is in there for a strike, 0-1. Strike one, 0-1. Here comes the pitch.
Well, Ron.
So it's Ron Dutt leading things off for the Rams here in the third inning. One, two pitch coming. That's way outside for a ball. Two balls and two strikes to count. Here's the pitch. That's missing. And three balls and two strikes to count. Here comes the pitch. That hits a ground ball to the shortstop. That is Walsh. Throws over to Feeney. And Dutt's gone for out number one. 6-3 putouts to score.
Go Junior!
Now batting number 19, Junior Madera.
The Junior Madera comes to play. During the last six games, San Francisco has been outscored 66-12 with a run differential of minus 54 as Madera swings and fouls that one back. So when you're just, you know, it's a, we have a one ball, one strike count. Here comes the pitch. And it's not that I'm trying to, as a put down, but it's not easy. I mean, have to break down the stats though. So it's a one ball, two strike count. One and two the count. Here comes the pitch. And that's going to cost Madera a strike. As he did go around at strike three, Madera goes down on strike. There's two men gone.
Number eight, Mark Zoom.
That'll be strikeout number two for the X-Man, Xavier Marquez. Two men gone. Mark Zoom will come to the plate. Here comes the pitch, and that's low for a ball. It's the set. Here comes the pitch, and Zhu swings, and that one goes foul, and that evens the count at 1-1. So it's an even count at 1-1. Here comes the pitch. That's outside for a ball. Now it's 2-1. Two balls and one strike to count. Two and one. Here's the pitch. And it's now 3-1.
I can not hear.
Three balls and one strike. As the lefty Marquez throws, and it's a strike two for Mark Zhu. So Zhu looked like he got ball four, but it's a 360 about face now. Full count, 3-2. Full count, three balls and two strikes. Here's the pitch. And Zhu stays alive as he goes foul. Zhu last week hit a two-run homer to count for the Rams. Only two runs in their 8-2 loss to Skyline around this time last Thursday over in Skyline out in San Bruno. Full count, 3-2 pitch on the way, and it's outside, ball four.
Now batting number 44, Jackson Wood.
So Jackson Wood will come to the plate. So it's a two outs here. It's Wood is. That pitch is in there for a called strike. It's 0-1. And it's 0-1. It's the set. Here's the pitch. And a ground ball to the third baseman. And that is the third baseman is Costello. Throws it over there. That's it. 5-3 put out. So now that is for the 3-4-5. So no runs, no hits. That's it for the Rams after 2.5, 2-0 Gladiators. So we now go to the bottom half of the frame of the third inning. It's 2-0 in favor of Chabot over San Francisco. And that pitch is a ball, even to count at 1-1. It's Walsh, the heart of the lineup, Walsh, Burham, and Morton. Here comes the 1-1 pitch. That pitch is in there for a strike, and it's now 1-2. One ball and two strikes to count. Jordan, he throws, and it's outside. Now it's a two-ball, two-strike count. Two balls and two strikes to count. It comes a 2-2. And he swings, and that one goes foul. remains at two balls and two strikes. Nice, beautiful afternoon here in Hayward in the East Bay. Oh, it hits a drive to deep right center. It's a right fielder, and coming up with the grab is Price as Walsh is retired. All right, one more gone. What do I hear? So now the next man up will be Daniel Berman will come to the plate for Chabot. Here's the pitch. It's breaking ball high for a ball. It's 1-0. Sets. Here comes the pitch. That pitch is in there for a strike. It's now evens the count at 1-1. Gets a set. Here comes the pitch. Popped up. It's the center fielder Maduro camps under there, and Vernon is retired for out number two.
Batting for the Gladiators, number 34, Noah Morton.
So now coming to the plate will be Noah Morton to the plate for Chabot. Here's the pitch. And that's outside corner for strike one, 0-1. This is set. Here comes the 0-1 pitch. It's swing and a miss. And it's now strike two. That's no balls and two strikes to count. It's the set. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. And it's low and for a ball. It's now 1-2. One ball and two strikes a count. Gets a sign for Esquivez. And time has been called. Has been called by the home plate umpire. We're going to give you all the updates around college baseball in the CCCA update, the 3C2A conference update, all around throughout community college baseball. We'll also give you scoreboard of the Division I Bay Area scoreboard and Major League Baseball. As swinging that one going foul is Morton. He's still alive at one ball, two strikes. First of a three-game series will be over at Mission College on Thursday over at Santa Clara. One ball, two strike, the count. Here comes the pitch. And it's just missing, and it's now evens the count at 2-2. It's the set. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. And just now it's a full count, 3-2. Three-two pitch coming. Here's the pitch. And a ground ball to Zoo, the shortstop. He will throw the wood, and that's a great play by Mark Zoo. That's it. So that's the first time in this contest. It's a quick 1-2-3 for Montoya. No runs, no hits, nobody left. After 3-4 complete, the Rams trail the Gladiators to Chabot 2-0. You're watching City College Rams Baseball on SidelineHD.com. It's good because they're running out of time.
Miguel Escobez. Now batting, number 25, Jordan Renteria. Now batting, number 14, Faraday. Gladiators, number 27, DJ Ostello.
Hey, I just went by to watch what I heard. I go hard in the
bang for the Gladiator, number 6, Liam Forsyth. Batting for the Gladiators, number 7, Gabe DiBenedetto.
Thank you. So, it's no runs, no hits, nobody left. And after four complete, or it is 2-0 in favor of the Gladiators.
Why does it keep looking? Are you catching it or anything?
I'm trying not to catch that spot. I'd rather have it right there, but then you make...
That works right there.
Okay.
You can move it around.
All right. Did the play come out to play? The last play?
I don't know. I just knew that I could take care
of
it. All right. Watch the light. If you start clicking again, it's fine.
Okay. Okay.
Got one on the field.
Okay. So it's good. Okay.
So we now go to the top half of the fifth inning, and a scheduled hitter for
he swings and that one goes foul.
No balls and one strike to count. Here comes the pitch. Half swing, and it's going to cost him a strike. It's now 1-2. And that pitch gets under the glove by the catcher, Foresight. Now it remains at 2-2. One ball, two strikes. The count, here comes the pitch. As swings and that one goes foul. Price at the plate so far is 0-1. Here's the pitch. It's way outside. Now it's evens the count now at 2-2. We'll get you on the scoreboard update around the community college scoreboard update in just a few moments. The pitch is high for a ball. It's now full count 3-2. Three balls and two strikes to count. Here is the pitch. Swing and a miss. As Price is going on strikes, now one man gone.
Number one, Ron Dutt.
Now bring up Ron Dutt to the plate. He grounded out his first time up. He's 0-1. It's the set. Here comes the pitch. And inside corner, strike one. By the way, we got a new pitcher coming in for Chabot. Here comes the pitch. We'll give it to you in just a moment. It is Daniel Velachico, a 5'11" freshman from Alameda, coming in to pitch for, and is just missing. Montoya's day is done for for the Gladiators. End up giving up four innings pitch. That swings and fouls it back. Giving up only one hit, no runs on one hit. He ended up walking none as Dutt is gone on strikes, two man gone. Marquez's final lines, four innings pitch, giving up no runs on one hit. And he ended up walking one with four strikeouts. Well, correction, he walked two. He had two walked the pair with one strike or four strikeouts. Here's the pitch. As Madrid rides one deep to left field, and that one goes foul. So he has a count now at one ball, one strike. Here's the pitch. That's in there for a strike, and it's now 1-2. Here comes the 1-2 pitch. It's a high fly ball to center field. It's the center fielder, Owens, camps under and makes the catch. So that's it for San Francisco. No runs, no hits, nobody left for the Rams. After four and a half, 2-0 in favor of the Rams. Or 2-0 in favor of the Gladiators. Rams trailed 2-0. So we now go to the fifth inning here. Bottom of the fifth inning here. Here's the pitch, outside for a ball. Leadoff here for Chabot College is Owens. Jalen Owens. Owens, a sophomore from Oakland. That pitch is now 2-1. Montoya has now retired the last six Gladiators. Here comes a 2-1 pitch. As Owens trying to bunt his way on, it goes fouled out. Evens the count at 2-2. At 2 balls and 2 strikes to count. Gets the set. Here's the pitch. Breaking ball, strike three called as Owens is going on strikes. One man gone. So that was a good, nasty, dirty breaking ball. Owens is going on strikes. So now go back to the top of the order for Chabot. And it, leading it off is Colin Fukuyuki, who has got himself a base hit. He's flied out. He's one for two. We'll give you the out-of-town scoreboard in just a moment and give you a look at the standings of the community college around, not just in this conference, but all throughout the state of California, or through the scoreboards as well. Here comes the pitch. And it's a ground ball to Zhu. Steps on it. Throws the first in. It gets away through the backstop. As Aaron will be charged to Zhu. So that would be an error with one out. So now the Rams are now in a double play mode as the, here's the pitch outside for a ball, 1-0. Daniel Berman, he's walked and he's flying out. He's 0-1. Well, I should say correction. It's Emmett Feeney to the plate. Here's the pitch. That's in there for a strike, and it's now 2-1. And going back over there to first base. Count is 1-1. Here's the pitch. As Escobar's attempt to make a throw over there, and he bluffs. Now it's 2-1 coming. It's a set. Here comes the pitch. And breaking ball just missing. Now it's 3-1. It's 3-1 pitch coming. As Feeney hits that one foul, it goes out of play. Strike two. Full count, 3-2. Here's the pitch. As a strike. Throws a second. They get up. Not in time. As the ball was kicked out of the glove by the glove. And that would have been a perfect play by Escobar. But they do get the strikeout. So Feeney is going on strikes and a two-man gone. And for Fukuyuki, that's his second swipe bag of the game. That's two stolen bases. Second of this contest. Here's the pitch. And Wall swings and misses strike one. That would have been a great sensational play if the short, if the second baseman Dutt would have held on to that ball. And if the ball doesn't score out of his glove, that is a strikeout, put out, double play. This inning is done. And that is ripped in the right field for a base hit. as the winner called one. The ball gets away by Price as going away to second as Wilson will go all the way to third, going back into the play. That is a base hit and a two-base error as Walsh will get an RBI on the play. Then you add the two extra base error. So,
keep feeling, Jordan.
And coming in to score is Fukuoka. So when they didn't quite get the pull out strikeout play, and the error hurt though too. So now it's 3-0. Here comes the pitch, and it's outside, missing for a ball, 1-0. Here comes the pitch. And that's low in the dirt for a ball. He gets the set here because the pitch. And that hits him. Bowman gets hit, and now the inning continues.
Number 34, Noah Orton.
So Mario Mendoza, the head coach for the Rams, is going to come out. So we're going to take a look at the scoreboard, what's going on right now. Rest of the action, baseball scoreboard around the community college. Right now in the fifth is 6-5 Pasadena leading East Los Angeles. Mount San Junito leads Chaffee 2-0 top of the eighth. Soterios leads Compton 2-0. Cuesta leads Porterville 9-2. And then looking at some of the rest of the conference scores, the Yans and Kenyatta, they're top of the fifth inning over in Cupertino, not far down the road. 1-1, they're top of the fifth. And then Las Maduras and Napa Valley, they're getting underway. The pitch is a strike 1-1 for Morton, the designated hitter. So far, he has been hit by a pitch. He's grounded out. He's 0-1 officially. West Valley leads Cabrillo 8-2. And the runner throws, and they got the runner picked off. And the runner's trying to go for home. They get the out there, and it will not matter. That run will not count because they put the tag on, and that it's going to be a one. So, it's going to be probably a one to four. So, Brennan is gone, and that's it. So, 1-1 on a hit. One runner is, and there is one runner left on base. And after five complete, 3-0, the Rams trail the Gladiators. So now, according to the scheduled hitters, so it'll be Mark Zut to the plate. Mario Mendoza having a conference chat. Let's take a look around the baseball standings in the 3C 2A North Division Conference and the North Coast Division. Skyline right now, they're 9-0. They've won 11 in a row. Chabot sits at second place. This game has significance. They're in second, a half game ahead of San Mateo. Kenyatta and the your Rams are tied for fourth place. The Anza sits in the basement, dead last at 1-7 on a six-game losing streak. We're having a little bit of a conference call going with there's a head coach for the Gladiators. Looking at some of that scoreboard watching right now. And it's 5-4 Skyline, bottom of the third. And they're in first place right now. Skyline has a game. They're 2.5 up on Chabot. They're 3 up on San Mateo. Chabot, this is an important game there. The pitch. Time for a ball, 1-0. Here the pitch, and Zoo whips one into center field for a base hit.
Now batting, number 44, Jackson Wood.
That's a base hit. That will be hit number two for the Rams. So that brings up Jackson Wood to the plate. Here comes the pitch, and it's high outside for a ball.
Good.
Here comes the pitch. That's a strike, and it's now two balls and one strike. Gets the set. Here comes the pitch. And it's inside corner, strike two. So Wood so far has reached on base with the ball. He's grounded out. He's 0 for 2. Here comes the pitch. And where is the ground ball? The second. There's an out there. Go the first. And that's a double play. That's a 4-6-3 double play. Esquivez is, or I should say, Wood is going for out number two.
Come back.
Heading 22, Miguel Esquivez.
So Miguel Esquivez comes up. He's 0 for 1. Here comes the pitch, and that's going to cost him a strike. It's 0-1. Nice state facility here in Chabot College. You see the upper hill up there out in left field where some fans are up there watching. Great shot there. Perfect spot to have a nice tailgate or a little picnic in the background. Here comes the pitch. Fly ball deep center field. Camping under it is Owens. He comes up with the grab, and that's it. So that's it. No runs on one hit. Nobody left. And after 5.5, 3-0, Gladiators lead the Rams.
And that's home, sweet tea, pecan pie, homemade wine, where the peaches grow.
Sixth inning, and the scheduled hitters for Chabot will be Morton, Costello, and Forsyth. Swings and misses, strike one. One point, Montoya starting to pitch better. He got retired six straight Gladiators before then. In the fifth, the previous inning, as Fukaluki reached on the air, he had a stolen base. He struck out. He at one point retired as he hits a fly ball to right field, and camping under the right fielder Price, as Morton is retired for out number one.
I just went by the watch with a whole lot of diamonds. It's a shawty, shawty, my turn. Took a trip out to Cali to hang with the Chris, make a plan, get high,
bitch. Looking at that, the conference getting down towards the stretch drive. Skyline with a win today kind of creased their win streak to 11 in a row. They would be, if they win today, they'll be four up on San Mateo. Chabot, of course, with this win today, they will remain. They'll be 7-2. They will remain two games. They're right now 2.5 games back. If Chabot wins, then, or Skyline wins, they'll be 2.5, maybe three up, but two could be two game remained at least having a 2.5 game, two game lead. The pitch, as Costello swings and misses, and it's now 2-1. Two ball, one strike count. Rams are in double plate depth. Breaking ball in there for called strike two. As an even count, 2-2. Two balls and two strikes to count. Here comes the pitch. And strike three called as Costello's going on strikes. That's another strikeout for
batting for the Gladiators.
For Montoya.
Number six. Liam Forsyth.
That is going to be strikeout number 5 strikeouts as Esquivez goes camps and try to get back over at first base. Is so it's one man gone here. The pitch. That's outside for a ball. Gets the set. Here's the pitch. Now it's 3-1. Here comes the 3-1. Popped up. And that's going to go foul. Now it's 3-4 count, 3-2. 4 count, 3 balls and 2 strikes. Gets the set. Here comes the 3-2. Breaking ball just missing outside. It's ball 4. So Forsythe will reach on base. Two of the last 3 plate appearances. Wharton will now advance to second. Now at the plate now is Gabe DiBenedetto at the plate. DiBenedetto is 0-2. The pitch outside. Esquivel's throwing the first as Forsythe gets back in there safely. Huh? All right. Correction, we have a pinch hitter. Tyson Brown is pinch hitting. Thanks. He is pinch hitting for DiBenedetto as Brown swings and misses. So we had a late entry in the pinch hit. Tyson Brown, a 6'3" freshman from Pinole, that's up there. That's going up there near Richmond. Ground ball to the shortstop, Zoo. He may throw too. There's out there throw the first. It is not in time. As Brown was able to beat that one out, the throw was a little too high from Ron Dutt. As Forsythe has been retired at second base, a 6'4" putout, and Brown reaches on a fielder's choice. Now coming to the plate now with 2 outs is Jalen Owens. Here comes the pitch. Brown going through. Oh, and Esquivez could not. There's nothing he could do on that play with 2 outs because the runner at third, Wharton, who advanced on the play, was going bad, dashing to the plate, and he went back to throw at the last minute. So Esquivez, there's nothing he could do on that. Here's the pitch. And a ground ball. Great play by Garibay. Want to get there? Got him! Great play by Angel Garibay. Taking away a possible 2 runs. Another sensational play by Angel Garvey, and the inning is over. So, they get no runs on one hit, and they leave a pair on base after six full complete. Gladiators still lead the Rams 3-0. You're watching City College Rams baseball on presented by SidelineHD.com. Seventh inning, and the scheduled hitters for the Rams will be Renteria, Garvey, and Williams. Brian Professor B. Davis here at the beautiful campus of Chabot Community College here in Hayward, just about east part here in the East Bay in the Alameda County. Pitch is outside for a ball, 1-0. Renteria continuing his struggles at the plate. He is 0-2. He is struck out and he is grounded out. Here is the pitch. That's in there for a strike. We're going to give you the scoreboard update around Division One, Bay Area Division One baseball coming up in just a moment. A look around the Bay Area teams in the West Coast Conference. And as Renteria swings and misses, strike 2, 1-2. Look around the West Coast Conference action for tonight and for the Pac-12 Conference. 1-2. Here's the pitch. Swing on and miss. Or is a foul. Foul. So he slices it foul. So that means Renteria still stay alive. One ball and two strikes to count. Also, we'll give you a full update of the conference standings as well. The pitch. And that's going to cost him a strike. As he did go, couldn't quite hold up the trigger. So, Renteria.
Now batting number 14, Angel.
Goes back into the dugout. One man gone. Take a look at from yesterday's scores. Sacramento State defeating San Francisco 7-1. So Sac State hands San Francisco their fourth consecutive, the Dons their fourth consecutive loss. Dons coming out that weekend getting swept by their West Coast WCC rival Santa Clara on the hilltop. That pitch is high for a ball. It's 1-2 to Garvey. Santa Clara completing their first three-game series sweep on the hilltop since 2003. Swing on and miss, strike 2-3. Garvey's gone on strikes, two men gone.
Now batting number 6, Donovan
Williams. They've beaten San Francisco now back-to-back season sweeps. They swept them last year over at Schott Stadium. They sweep them again this year. All three of those games by at least two runs or less. Santa Clara completing their first series sweep on the hilltop in 21 years. They have now beaten the Dons now 9 of their last 10 and currently the last 6 straight. You can see had two programs, Bay Area rivals, in contrast, going opposite into the spectrum. Here's the pitch. That's high for a ball. There's the pitch to Williams, and that's a ball. As
now batting,
the base on balls, as Mario Mendoza will talk with the home plate umpire. One point USF had dominated that rivalry with Santa Clara.
Now batting, number 23, David Howard.
And David Howard comes in to pinch hit, and it's a ball. They end up winning 11 straight series from 2009 in conference till 2021. Howard swings and misses, and it's 1-1. So it'll be Howard coming in to pinch hit. Howard hits a ground ball to the second baseman. They'll get the force play there. That's a 4-6 putout. And that's it. So, no runs on, no hits, nobody left, or one run left. And after six and a half complete, it's 3-0 in favor of the Gladiators. So while we're taking this time out, let's just give you a rundown of the scores. So, USF was losers, but give back that story. One point they had. One point, USF had won 11 of 13 series versus Santa Clara. And in that time frame,
my loving, oh, and I know she'll be the death of me, at least for good enough. And she'll always get the best of me, the worst is yet to
4 times they swept the Broncos, but now it's the down.
Look at the West Coast Conference standings right now. Portland sits at 3-0. They have won 7 in a row. San Diego sits at 4-2. Them and St. Mary's are both dead even for second, but St. Mary's has that tiebreaker advantage over them. If the season ended today in the West Coast Conference, and that will be a strike. St. Mary's would be the number 2 seed. They would get a first round bye along with Portland. San Diego would be the number three seed. Pepperdine's 4-2. They'll host San Francisco this weekend. And it's a ground ball into right field for a base hit. That's for Colin Fukuoka. Colin Fukuoka, the Hawaii native. Takes it into right field for a base hit. Second hit for Fukuoka. Defensive change for San Francisco. Howard, the right fielder, who pinch hit, he will now play left field. He will replace Williams. That pitch is not in there for a ball. One and one. Here comes the pitch. The runner's going and swings, and that's a fly ball in deep, and that's going to go out of play. And the pitcher swings, and that one goes foul. And the runner's going. The ball's dropped by Esquivez. And that's going to be a stolen base for Fukuoka will get his second stolen, or his third stolen base of the game. So now evens count of 2-2. He had a pair of hits, and he has stolen three bags in this contest. Now it's full count, 3-2. Three balls and two strikes to count. Here's the pitch. Breaking ball, ground ball to the third baseman. He has his time. And Garvey throws! Got him! Great, another sensational play by Angel Garvey, taking away a base hit for Vinny. Garvey's having a sensational day defensively on the hot corner. So one man gone. He's now had five putouts or five assists this afternoon. One man gone now. Nicholas Walsh will come to the plate with one man gone. The pitch is outside for a ball, 1-0. Fukuoka will remain at second with one out. Here comes the pitch. That is an outside corner called strike. Here comes the pitch. It's a high fly ball deep left field, and it will stay in the yard as Howard camps under it, makes the catch. Fukuoka tags and blessing will go back to second. Two men gone.
Batting for the Gladiators, number two, Daniel Berman.
So Daniel Berman, Berman will come to the plate with two men gone. Here comes the pitch. It hits outside that corner. Strike one, 0-1. So no balls, one strike to count. Here's the pitch. And it's outside for a ball, and it's 1-1. Here comes the pitch. Breaking ball as Berman fouls it, went back. That's a one ball, two strike count. Looking at West Coast Conference. Looking at it, it's Portland, San Diego, St. Mary's, Pepperdine. They're in a three-way tie for second. Gonzaga. And the pitch. That's a pop-up. And it's going to be Montoya. He will camp under and makes the catch. That's it for the Gladiators. So, no runs, one hit, one runner left on base. And after seven complete here in Chabot College, Graham still chill, 3-0. So we've had some defensive alignment changes for Blake Jacobs. He'll play at third base. He'll replace Costello. It's a fly ball pop-up, and it is the shortstop. Walsh camps under there to make the catch, and we had a pinch hitter for the Rams. Coming up there making the catch. And making that pinch hit was number 16. Where ground ball to the shortstop. It's Walsh again. Kingston throws over the first to Finney to retire Medina. Two man gone. Taking away a base hit. 6-3 put out. Two man gone. We're trying to see it was Brian Barbara. Bar came in and pinch hit for Ron Depp. That pitch is outside for a ball 1-0. Zero is 1-4-2, reach base in 2 or 3 plate appearances. Here's the pitch. And a ground ball. That's a great play by the shortstop. He this time not going to be able to do nothing about it. And that's another hit for Zoo. Zoo will be 2-for-3 at the plate. And he has reached 3 times on base, total bases in 3 or 4 plate appearances. So now Jackson Wood will come to the plate, and he's trying to get on base. If he can get on, That would lead up to, as Will Trice went to deep left field, and it's the left fielder, Deep and Nitty, making the catch. That's a quick inning. So it's no runs and one hit, one ram there left on base. And after seven and a half, it's 3-0. Rams trailing the Gladiators of Chabot.
Or the one night, promise if I could, I'd do it twice to say. Put them on pause, press play. Hold on at that point. I know my life is so crazy, but I don't get you right here. You're really so awesome. Nothing can stop us. I don't know you with no fear. We can do this thing together. Close your eyes and take my hand. Cause what we have is something special, baby. Let's just take our chance.
And then, it's me, it's in a real mirror, all right.
Last week I was in Paris with my dad. Only thing that was missing was you. Who would have thought we would be married by now? We've been true lovers since high school. Let's live our life, dancing all night. You are where you should be, I want this for life. What you say? Put them on pause, press play. I'm on my life, I think it's so crazy, but
we got some more defensive changes now coming into play at second base. Is George Thompson? He will replace Dutt. George Thompson will come in, and the leadoff hitter for will be number 34. Noel Morton will come to the plate. Morton so far this afternoon, here's the pitch, and it's outside missing, and it's a ball 2-0, or 1-1, correction, my bad. Morton is 1-for-2, and he has also reached base by hit by pitch. The pitch is outside for the ball, and then now coming in, the pitch is Renteria. We'll give you the final totals on Montoya. He went 7 innings pitched. Here's the pitch. Oh, just missing. It's 3-1. Three balls and one strike to count. And it's a strike. Montoya's numbers, he ended up going 7 innings pitch, and he gave up 3 runs. And I believe it's going to be at least 2 of them were earned on 5 hits. The pitch, That's ball four. One will reach on base with a walk. We'll give you an update of what's going on the baseball scoreboard.
Jacobs.
So they'll have a pinch runner in it. Coming out the run will be Brady Weasel, a utility player. He's going to run for Morton. He'll come in and pinch run. Blake Jacobs, who came in, he's going to come to the plate. Runner's going. And that's another stolen base for the Gladiators. No, they did not. He hit batsman correction. So while that's going on, San Mateo has exploded now. It's 10-5 over Skyline. 1 point they trail 5-4. They're now at the bottom of the sixth inning. They have a commanding 10-5 lead. And then top of the eighth inning, Kenyatta and DeAngelis 3-3 tie top of the eighth inning over in Cupertino. And then Las Maduras will play Napa Valley. We don't have no cup score on that game. And then Laney over there at Laney College over in Oakland. 17-4, bottom of the sixth inning. They're trying to end their losing streak over in Oakland. Or is it first and second for the nobody out? Oh, and that gets away. And that is just a Thompson's in and out of his glove. Aaron should be charged to the pitcher. They now get a cheap 90 bases. Third error for San Francisco. Forsythe, the catcher. Here comes the pitch, breaking ball, and he swings, and that one goes foul, strike one. Montoya's final line of the game. He had 7 innings pitched. He gave up five hits, 3 runs, 2 of them earned, with 5 strikeouts. He ended up walking. Walked 2 and the hit by pitch. Here comes the pitch. And another upstairs breaking ball. As Forsythe try to hit that one, it goes foul off the screen. Count remains at 1-2. the set. Here comes the 1-2. And it's just way too low, and it's now evens the count at 2-2. On deck is Tyson Brown. Here comes the pitch. Oh, just missing. Borderline pitch. Has a full count. Full count, 3 balls and 2 strikes. Here comes the pitch. And a liner off the glove of the diving Jew for a base hit. That will score two. And that ball going all the way around. Forsythe on its way to second. It's a 2-run double for Liam Forsythe as the Gladiators now increase their lead to 5-0. Forsythe has now had 3 RBIs of the day. He has a solo home run. He has a 2-run double. He has driven in 2 more runs. He has 3 RBIs for the day. And it's now a 5-0 lead for the Gladiators. So now coming to the plate is Brown, or correction, I should say, coming to the plate is Tyson Brown to the plate. Here comes the pitch, and it's low in the dirt for a ball. And we've been talking about all throughout the game, it's all about throwing strikes, and you know, you have to get ahead of the hitters. You can't be nibbling. You have to pitch inside. You, when you're ahead, you try to challenge the hitters. Gets the set. Here comes the pitch. And that is ripped in the right field, and that's going to fall for a base hit as Forsythe coming all the way to the score, standing up. And for RBI for Tyson Brown. And it's now a 6-0 game.
Number
20. So it's a 6-0 game now, and still with no outs. Here's the pitch, it's low in the dirt, man, for a ball, 1-0.
That worked. Me too, but
and ripped one to deep right field. Back goes Howard, and that's going to the wall. As Brown is on his way to third, he will go all the way. Here comes the throw, no contest. And that is an RBI double for Camilo Rivera. He drove one deep to right field over the head of the right fielder, Williams, I should say. It's a double. It's now a 7-0 game.
Batting for the Gladiators, number 9, Colin Cookie.
Back-to-back doubles in this game. So not a good outing for Jordan Renteria. So he goes in, and we're going to have another pitching change. We're going to give you an out-of-town scoreboard update. Lady College leads Mendocino 14-7. And then you look at the other scores. Top of the eighth inning is 3-3. DeAnza and Canada are playing over at Cupertino. We're going to take this time out. It's going to be Muhammad Ahmed pitching for San Francisco. So Fukiyuki will come back and hit in this inning. Pitches in for a ball, so now Camilo Rivera will be at second. Hits a fly ball to right field. The second baseman, Thompson, comes in there with a catch. Tagging up is Rivera. So we got one out in the inning. So Fukioki retired. So Fukioki for the day, he would go. He will end up going. Two for four of the plate. He ended up reaching also in the air. Two out of. Here comes the pitch. And he pops it up foul. Plenty of real estate for Wood. And Wood camps in there and makes a catch. He nearly tried to keep his balance in foul territory. And Beanie is drawn for out number two.
Not even one either.
Nick Walsh. This is hitter number eight. Nick Walsh will now come to the plate. They've scored three more times in the inning.
Who scored the seventh run?
So they've scored four times in this inning. It's a ball now 3-2. Just apologize for the inconvenience. We're just trying to keep things on the scores table. So just to keep things, you know, corrected, try to keep up what's going on our score chart. So here comes the 3-2 pitch. And that's ripped in the right field, and that's going to fall in, base hit. Brown will come in, or I should say, Roberto comes in to score.
So every day I spend my time drinking wine, feeling fine.
Batting for the Gladiators, number two, in Thurman.
So now they have sent their number nine hitter, sent nine, the ninth guy's coming to plate this inning. They have now scored four times in this, or I said they scored five in this inning. And now going into the steal second is Walsh. So for Liam Forsythe, he's gotten three RBIs and he has two extra base hits. So far in this inning, they have two extra base hits in this inning. Ahmed throws high fly pop up, foul territory, Howard and Zoo, and they run out of real estate, goes out of play. Evens the count now at one ball and one strike. And a breaking ball high. Two balls and one strike to count with two outs. Pitches in there for a ball. So a look around the West Coast Conference action around Bay Area College Baseball. Looking in there, there should be a good race to the end. Portland, San Diego, St. Mary's, Pepperdine's 4-2. It's a four-way tie for second. Santa Clara in a must-series win, bouncing back after getting swept by Portland last weekend. The previous weekend, nearly 10 days ago over in, or I should say 12 days ago, almost 2 weeks ago, coming back and sweeping San Francisco. Boy, look at the two teams now in contrast, and opposite ends of the spectrum. USF will play Pepco down to play Pepperdine this weekend. Breaking balls to drive the deep left field. Howard is going to run out of one foul. Won't be able to come up with the catch. So Berman's still alive at full count, 3-2. They'll be playing them for a three-game series then in 2 weeks. And a week after that, they'll play Cal next week, 1 week from tonight over in Berkeley. Then they'll play a three-game series against Gonzaga. It does not get any better for San Francisco. And look where that franchise program was, where they were 2 years ago, and where they are now. Here's the pitch. And that's ripped in the center field. That's another base hit. Coming all the way to scoring as Walsh, as making the big bluff is Brennan. So that's an RBI. And the Gladiators have batted all around. They have now, it's a 9-0 game. 9-0 game. And now coming to the plate is Brady Wetzler, who pinch ran for the designated hitter, Noah Morton. Here comes the pitch, and that pitch is low for a ball. One ball, no strikes. And going back over there to first base. Here comes the pitch. That's a strike, and it's now 1-1. Evens accounted, one ball, one strike. Here comes the pitch, and a liner caught by Thompson. And at last, the inning is over. But the damage has been done. The damage already done, as the Gladiators have put up an ugly, ugly, ugly duckling score, 6 runs. They get on the play. They end up seeing 2 big errors on 5 hits. And they leave a pair on base. And we go to the ninth. And it's last call for the Rams. They trail 9-0. You're watching City College Rams Baseball on Sideline. HD.com. I mean, she even cooks me pancakes. Sit out myself so when my tummy aches. If that ain't love, then I don't know what love is. We even got a secret handshake, and she loves the music that my band makes. I know I'm young, but if I had a juice over the sun, I'd be a nocturnal son of a gun. Take a look at my girlfriend, as the Rams have now lost 7 in a row. They have now lost 10 of their last 12 as they fall to the Gladiators of Chabot College by a score of 9-0. So we're going to take this brief timeout. We'll come back in a few moments for the final totals in just a few moments. You're watching City College Rams baseball on StreamlineHD.com/City College Baseball.
We'll have to clean this up and close it up. So.
Huh?
We'll have to clean up the roof and close
it up. Okay, all right. All right. I'm going to do a quick one, though. All right. This afternoon, 9-0 as the City College Rams get shut out again. So the offensive struggles continue for San Francisco. Tough luck losing for Jordan Montoya. Pitched very well enough to win. He 1 point retired five consecutive hitters. So he drops to 0-4, but the loss in the loss column do not reflect. He pitched well enough, but just the offense continue to struggle. San Francisco has now been shut out now for the fourth time in the last 7 games, and they have scored at least in that time frame. They have, in the time frame, they have ended up scoring at least 2 runs or fewer in the 8 or 3 in at least 6 of their last 7 or 5 of the last 7 games. So really nothing more to say. They dropped to 2-8 in conference, 8-19 overall, and Chabot improves to 21-8 overall, 9-2 in conference. And then you look at the scoreboard showing on that the last we heard, College of San Mateo was winning over. They were winning over Skyline, so the chance for them, for the Chabot to pick up some ground. Top of the eighth inning, DeAnza trails Kenyatta 4-3. I'd like to thank everybody here. I'd like to thank the athletic department. Ruben Zimmer is our camera guy getting us set up. Next broadcast will be at Mission College Thursday afternoon, 2:30 first pitch. We will go on the air at 2:20 p.m. Pacific Standard Time for the pregame show. Latest news on City College Athletics and so much more. Go to CCSFAthletics.com and check out all the community college scoreboard updates. Go to CCCAASports.org. That's CCCAASports.org. For now, Brian, Professor B. Davis, and so on. Let's give the final score. The Rams were shut out by Chabot this afternoon by a score of 9-0. From here at Chabot College here in Hayward, Brian, Professor B. Davis, signing off. You've been watching City College Rams baseball on Sideline HD TV. And wish all of you have a very pleasant good evening.